So far, so good. The only thing I feel like every time I move, I'm making a static sound. It's okay, I guess. You don't hear it? Love it. So once again, thank you so much. And just as a gratitude is such a great vibration to start with. It is really increases our good vibes, our kind of parasympathetic nervous system gets a little bit more balanced. So let's take a moment here and acknowledge everybody in the Hollywood Square and send some gratitude to each other for our support for this class. Thank you, everybody. Let's do a couple of nice deep breaths here. Being present, being here for yourself and for each other. Thank you. So I'm going to start with this 10-step protocol, and that simply means that we're going to be opening the main drains of our lymphatic system. And the importance of that is kind of like we've talked about the analogy of a toll booth and a lot of cars waiting to move towards those toll booths. If you don't have the toll booths open, then the cars are just waiting there to move. But once they see the green light, which is what we're going to be doing by opening them up, then the cars can move smoothly. And that's what Babs is going to be doing, is encouraging the lymphatics to just do their thing, but kind of like encourage it to move towards these drainage areas. The drainage areas that we're attending to is based on the anatomy of the lymphatic system. So we are going to be focusing actually on like the areas here of the neck, the areas of the axilla, the cubital fossa. The belly is very big because we have a lot of lymphatics there, the inguinals, and the back of the knee. And then we go back to the belly and then back to the neck, because these are like, since this is the main drain, the end drain where everything eventually goes. So we give emphasis to these two areas. So let's begin. And I'm going to be doing about 5 strokes per area. They've shown that 5 to 8 strokes are usually very effective in opening these drainage areas. And I know it's a very hard thing for me to talk about pressure, because you can't really. It's hard to describe, but if you are experiencing a skin stretch towards that area that you are draining, if you can see that, then you're doing a good job. You also can't harm yourself if you do just a light touch. It's okay too. They haven't shown any kind of adverse effects in doing any lighter touch. So let's start here at the sternal notch. And I'm gonna form a like reverse C on my hand. We're gonna be using a big part of our hand here, and we're gonna put it in the middle if you can. If you have a port or any device, you can move away from it and just redirect your stroke towards this area. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next area is going to be our neck, sides of our neck. The way I do this is this direction, but you can also do it this way if you want to. The reason why I do it this way is because I can also get the lymphatics that are in the front and the back of my ear. And the direction is going to be to the direction of the drainage area that we just opened. So let's do this. 5 strokes. 1, down, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Also, if you can do this on your skin, it's great, but it doesn't, again, no adverse effects if you're doing it over clothing. So for the shoulder, I'm doing it on my skin. So I'm actually under my shirt here, and I'm going to pump again towards the sternal notch, hugging myself, and I'm going to be pumping down towards the sternal notch. So let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next will be the armpit. We have a lot of axillary nodes here, and currently the studies show that it is really okay to stimulate and still support the area that was affected by any like dissection or radiation. So when we stimulate the armpit, we are pushing it a little bit down and again towards the direction of the sternal notch. So, and the other additional tip is if you can move your arm, the lymphatics love movement. So we do a pump and a move. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you can do bigger, that's good. If you can only do here, that's good. If you can only do here, you can just pump in this direction. Everything is good. Next, the other side, let's get that axilla. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Cubital fossa or back of the elbow. Here, I'm going to be pumping up towards my axilla, down and up. So kind of, when I say down and up, it's like, think about it as like a dropper or like as a turkey baster, right? You like press something to have a vacuum and then release. So I'm pressing down a little bit and then up a little bit towards the axilla. And here you can do a bicep curl. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Next is going to be our belly. First, we're going to start on the upper belly. And all we're doing here is doing a nice inhale. And when we inhale, we expand the belly out. And then when we exhale, we're pressing in a little bit, gently guiding into the basically closer to the spine. So let's breathe in together. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Exhale, exhale, exhale. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Exhale, exhale, exhale. Lower belly. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Exhale, exhale, exhale. Inhale, inhale, inhale. Exhale, exhale, exhale. Take a little break. We're going to go into the inguinal area or the groin area. If you put your thumbs in your belly button where your fingers land, or if you fold your, lift your knee up where your crease is here, that's what we're going for. So we're going to pump towards the belly buttons like so. So pump in and up. So like it's almost like a scoop, okay? So let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The way I add a motion to this is I might be seated if I need support, and I kind of do a slow march. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The next one is the back of our knee. I'm going to lift my leg up here. Oops. Sorry. Babs, am I like going staticky? Okay. I think it's every time I'm this thing. It's the, all right, back of the knee. Sorry, guys. Pump, pump up towards your groin. 2, 3, 4, But other side, I can also stay seated. One, two, three, four, and five. We're going to go back. We're going to go back to the belly, and we're going to address both the upper and lower belly at the same time. We're going to do another inhale, 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 exhale, exhale, exhale for two times. So when you're ready, inhale, 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 exhale, 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 inhale, 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 exhale, exhale, exhale. And last but not the least, we go back to our final drainage and do our reverse C again and go pump five times. One, two, three, four, five. Now everything is open for us to do our yoga. That's gonna help even move your lymphatics better. Let me just highlight Bab.
Okay. She's just gonna spotlight me now and then we'll begin. Can everyone see me okay? Okay, good. All right. So we'll begin. You can choose your seat. So you can sit in a chair, you can sit on the edge of the bed. If you want to sit up on a little bit of a bolster or a pillow underneath you, that's fine too. So just get yourself comfortable and we'll begin. So we'll start by just placing our hands into our lap. And then if it feels okay, you can close your eyes. And then just start to get settled here, just relaxing the shoulders down. And then we'll take a slow breath in through the nose for a count of three. And then a slow breath out through the mouth for a count of five. Breathing in for a count of three. And exhale for a count of five. Just starting to become more grounded and present in this moment together. Just allowing our energy to settle and balance and just prepare our mind and body for this next half an hour or so together, just to flow, to feel better. And then we'll place both hands at our heart center for a moment. And today's flow is going to be all about joy. So we're going to try to encourage joy into our lives, into our mind, into our body, and into our soul. So throughout our practice, I'll teach you some different affirmations just to bring in that sense of comfort, ease, and joy. So hands connected to the heart space, just connecting your physical body right to your heart. And then we'll place our palms together. And then I'll invite you to set your own positive intention or affirmation for today. So maybe take a moment just to, like Bambi said earlier, send some gratitude to yourself, to all of our community here that is joined with us. We're so happy that you came and we really love to share this practice with you all. So just take a moment to thank yourself and send good energy to your own body and mind. And then we'll slowly take a big breath in as we lift the arms up towards the sky as a way of bringing in new fresh energy to you. We'll exhale, draw that energy down through your heart center. Nice, inhale, big arm open, lift. And then exhale, draw everything in. So we've already stimulated and opened our major drain. So now through our yoga forms and our sequences, we help to encourage the drainage from all areas of our body. So let's take a few more matching breath to movement. So inhaling as you lift and reach, exhaling as you come down. A lot of our practice, the inhalation will be when we open and expand, and the exhalation will be when we come back to center and come inward. Good, one more time, nice job, everyone. Lifting up, reaching up. Exhale, slowly coming back down. Good, pause here for a moment, relax the shoulders. And then we'll take our hands to tap on the shoulders. It's okay if you can't quite reach it. And then we're gonna draw our elbows forward up towards the sky, out and around. Nice, big shoulder heart opener. Inhale as you draw the elbows forward and up. And then as you exhale, squeeze the shoulder blades as you come down. Good, breathing in, opening up. Exhale, make sure to start to feel comfortable with yourself. So without judgment, maybe you breathe a little bit more throughout the practice. Maybe you let out a big sigh in areas of relief. So feel free to listen to my guidance, but also listen to your internal state in that inner mind that says, ooh, that feels good. Let's do a little bit more. So we'll take one more and then release the hands down by your sides. We're going to open up the arms, spread the fingers wide, lift through the chin and the chest. Take a big breath in here. And then exhale, you're going to give yourself a gentle hug as you round and tuck the chin. So getting into the spine here, we're going to inhale, expand and open, spread your arms like wings. And then exhale, opposite arm comes on top as you hug in. Feel free to close your eyes. Inhale as you open, imagining just the energy coming into your body. And then as you exhale, you're pulling in warmth and love and joy. As you inhale, you're rocking your pelvis forward. You're expanding through the chest. Nice. And as you exhale, coming in. Let's take two more. This Friday practice is a really good one just to have a little bit of a separation from the week to the weekend. So we're going to release everything that might have happened throughout the week and just open ourselves up to a joyful, peaceful, happy weekend. Good. And then inhale, reach those arms up, stretch up. And then exhale, we're going to draw the elbows into the side body. Good. Inhale, open up, reach the arms. This time, if you'd like, you can create fists and then draw the elbows down. It's a little bit of a different sensation. Good. Inhale, lift. So our first part of our class, exhale, come down, is all about opening up through our chest because, as Bambi said, this is where the major drains are. So if we can open up and move the fluid here at the center, then the arm fluid and the extremity fluid has somewhere to go. If you're experiencing any lymphedema or swelling, the breast, armpit, this is a really good one to squeeze and promote lymph flow to our spinal lymph nodes that will help drain. Good, let's do one more, breathe in. Also really good for our posture. Nice exhale coming down. Perfect, and then palms facing up, elbows glued into the side ribs. Breathe in to open up through the chest, getting external rotation through the shoulders. And then exhale, just allow the pinkies to touch. Inhale, opening up, squeezing. Exhale, drawing back in. And then one more, inhale, open up. Exhale. And then arms come out in front of you, thumbs facing up. Wiggle the fingertips here. Breathe in. And then exhale, make tight fists, and you're gonna pull the shoulder blades together like you're rowing. Good. Inhale, reach forward, maybe get a little bit of openness throughout the thoracic spine there. And then exhale, you're pulling and squeezing. Good. Breathe in, reaching forward. Exhale. Breathe in. And exhale. Last one, breathe in. And exhale. And then release the arms down by your sides. If you're on the earth, you can plant your hands so that you tend to the fingertips so you sit up nice and tall. If you're in the chair, just hold on to the sides of the chair. And then we're going to gently just drop our chin towards our chest, getting a nice stretch through the back of the neck. And then we'll lift our gaze back up and we'll drop right ear to the right shoulder. You can use that right hand as a gentle little stretch, added stretch for the left side of your neck. Breathe in here. Just allowing the weight of that hand help with the stretch, but not to pull it down, just breathe. And then releasing that out, drop the chin back towards the chest. And then inhale, gaze comes back up, and we'll drop left ear, left shoulder, left hand to temple, and then just breathe here. Slowly inhaling, exhale, softening your body, and then release that hand, drop the chin down towards your chest one more time. And then we'll inhale, gaze back up, and then we'll plant through our right hand, we'll lift that left arm up. If you're in a chair, sometimes it's helpful to take that right hand across your body as just a little bit of a stabilizer. But if you're on the earth, you can use the earth. Breathe in here. Exhale, slowly side bend. Bendy's found a nice little place to eat his bone right now. And then you can stay here, or if you'd like, you can get a little bit of trunk rotation, a little bit of movement. So maybe if you'd like to, you can inhale as you open your body. Exhale as you come in. If you'd like a little bit more of a chest and pec stretch, you can bring your hand behind your head, so the thumbs by the neck, and then you can continue. So take about three more rounds wherever you feel is good for you. Taking a slow breath in and out. Remembering to inhale as you open, exhale as you draw in. Last round, breathing in. Nice and out. And then coming back to center, release that arm down by your sides. And we'll take our shoulders up towards our ears, back and down. Inhale, lifting up. Exhale, back and down. You can start to swim the arms with this motion. Nice. Just as a little release before we make it to our other side. Beautiful. And then release that left hand down. We'll reach the right arm up. Pause here for a moment. Take a breath in. Sit up nice and tall. And exhale, slowly side bend. Again, you can use that left hand across the body towards the right thigh. That gives a little bit more stability if you're in the chair. And then your choice. You can start to find a little bit of movement through the trunk, shining your heart towards the sky and then towards the earth. Maybe really reaching the arm back and then open feels nice. So listening to your body, what is going to spark some joy and good vibrations, good sensations into your heart? Maybe you bring the hand behind the head, thumb towards the neck or thumb staying with the index. Inhale to open, exhale to come across the body. Take three more rounds. Just noticing how this side feels. Noticing maybe what feels good for you right now. Maybe it's the first time all day you really stop to check in with your body and find a little release. Good. And then coming back to center, release that hand back down. We'll roll our shoulders again as a little bit of a counter form. Just breathing here in. And out, you can swim the arms. That sometimes feels very nice for the body. It's just a way to increase the energy and lymph flow. Really good if you have arm lymphedema too. Good, and then release the hands into the lap. And we're going to take some circles here. So now that we've opened up the chest, expanded through the shoulders, the neck, we're gonna get more into the abdominal region, then make our way down to the legs, and then we'll have a nice few moments of just relaxation. So we're going to start by taking a breath in, sitting up nice and tall, and then exhale, slowly drawing your body over towards the right thigh, center, left thigh, and then scooping all around. So if you're seated in the chair, inch your way towards the edge of the chair so that you have a little bit more room. And you might want to open up your legs a little bit wider too so that you can really get into this abdominal region. So just taking a few breaths in and out. Moving nice and slow. I always like to think of your kind of scooping that last little bit of peanut butter out of a peanut butter jar. So kind of getting in all these little nooks and crannies of your body. And then when you're ready, we'll switch. So go in the opposite direction. Breathing in and then out. If you're experiencing any lower body lymphedema, this is helpful to clear the fluid here at the center so that the pathways are now open. Good. And then we'll come back to center. Just take a breath here just to resettle. Take a slow breath in and out. And then if you're on the earth, we're gonna bring our hands behind us. Actually, if you're in the chair, you can, if you have a back to the chair, bring your arms behind so that they're onto the chair. And if you're on the earth, we're just gonna bring our hands behind us and just open up through our chest. So just a little gentle back bend, breathing in here. And exhale here. And then inhale, sweeping the arms all the way up. And then if you're on the earth, you're gonna bring your arms forward so you roll forward to come into all fours. But if you're seated in the chair, you're gonna place your hands right onto your thighs. And we're gonna take cat and cow. So if you're on the earth, spread the fingers wide, spread the toes wide, tuck the toes. And then on your next breath in, drop the belly, look forward, gaze forward, inhale. And then exhale, round and tuck and pull the heart up towards the sky. So flowing through this a few more rounds. If you're in the chair, you're gonna just draw your body forward as the pelvis tilts. And then you're gonna exhale and round and come through. So take about five more going at your own pace. If your wrists are uncomfortable, you can come up onto fists or down onto forearms. So respect your body, just breathing in and out. And then we'll come back to a neutral spine when you're ready. And we're gonna slowly extend through our right leg. So extending the right leg back if you're on the earth. If you're seated in the chair, you can extend the legs with the heels on the ground and if you're in the chair. And then we're gonna slowly just rock back and forth. If you're in the chair, you can slowly just bend so you get a little bit of a hamstring stretch in the chair. And then we're going to slowly lift through that right leg. If you're in the chair, you're gonna lift the right leg up, and then we're all gonna lift the left arm. So inhale to find length here, and then exhale, draw an elbow into the knee. So inhale, you're lengthening. Exhale, you're coming in. So if you're in the chair, you're gonna bring that knee up and you're gonna cross your body to bring elbow to knee. Nice job, everyone. Take two more, breathing in and out. Breathe in and out. And then release down. We'll come into a child's pose if you're on the earth. So widen the knees, big toes come together, arms extend. If you're seated in the chair, you're just going to allow the hands to come to the lap. Just let the chin come down and breathe. Just taking a few breaths here just to relax, check in with your body. Just bring a little bit of joy into the forehead, into the mind. And then slowly coming back up to center. And then we're going to extend through the left leg this time. And then rock forward and back. Getting into the calf, stretching a little bit here. If you're in the chair, just extending the leg, getting a little bit of a hamstring stretch. And then as you're ready, a little core activation, we're going to lift to the right arm, left leg, find length here. And then exhale, draw elbow into the knee. Four more times at your own pace. Keep the stability. Nice job, everyone. If you're in the chair, you're going to bring that knee across the body and then lift back up. Good job. Make sure you're breathing. Beautiful. I can see all of you doing so good. And then when you're complete, we're going to slowly come off of the wrists onto the shins. If you're in the chair, bend through the knees, inch your way towards the edge of the chair. And then we're going to take something called breath of joy. So this is a breathing practice that I really like and is a good thing to have kind of in your toolbox. So I'll demonstrate it first and then we'll do it all together. But it's three quick breaths in and then a long breath out. So some of you might have practiced it before, but it looks like this. You breathe in, breathe in, breathe in, and then a long exhale. You can see Benny's really into this breath. So it's three bursts of quick breaths in and a long release. So let's try five rounds together. So it's inhale, 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 exhale. Breathe in, breathe in, breathe in, exhale. Three more rounds. Breath in, breath in, breath in, exhale, let it go. Last two, breathe in, breath in. Nice job, everyone. Breathe in, exhale. Last one, breathe in, breathe in, breathe in, and let it go. And then slowly just start to take a seat again, a comfortable seat for a moment. Maybe check in with your heart rate, with the energy moving through you. You can feel free to close your eyes and let your shoulders soften. Just taking a moment to pause and let that breath come through you. And then we'll slowly make our way onto our back if we're on the floor. So one way I like to do this is clasping my hands underneath my thigh and then slowly lowering down. And then we'll all bring our right knee into our chest. So if you're in the chair, you're gonna draw that knee into the chest. That left leg can be long or it can be bent. And that same goes for the chair. If you're seated in the chair, you can lengthen the leg or keep it bent. And then we'll find some movement in this right hip. So creating some circular movements, creating some circles in the ankle, in the toes. Taking a slow breath in and out. Maybe reversing that circle, going in the opposite direction. And then from here, we're gonna take our hands behind the knee. So, and then we're gonna just massage gently as we straighten and bend through the right leg. So notice how it feels through the foot, through your hamstring, through your calf. If you're sitting up in the chair, make sure to sit up nice and tall, breathe in. And then exhale, slowly lowering that right leg all the way down as you bring the left leg into the chest. Left knee into left chest. And then again, finding some circular movements with this leg. You can keep that right leg extended long or keep it bent, whatever feels more nourishing in your body today. Noticing the sensations in this left hip. Breathing in and out. You can reverse it if you haven't already. And then slowly extending that left leg up towards the sky, massaging the back of the knee. And you can start to bend and straighten this leg. Checking in with this leg, breathing. And then if you're in the chair, just drop that leg down. But if you're on the floor, we're going to bring both knees into the chest and just rock and roll side to side. This is a little bit of a nourishing move on the spine. If you're in the chair, you can open up the legs wider and just let the knees knock from one side to the other. Slow breath in and slow breath out. Maybe massaging the back of the head if you're on the earth. And then when you're ready, we'll come into our final relaxation pose. So we'll start to extend the legs long. If you're in the chair, find a nice, cozy, comfortable seat. You can have the back supported now. And then options to place your hands on your belly, on your thighs, by your sides, whatever feels better. If your arms are laying on the earth, place the palms up. And then slowly take a breath in through your nose. And then exhale, let it go out of the mouth. Slow breath in through your nose. Open mouth, exhale, let it go. And the next time you breathe in your mind, say, I choose. Exhale to let joy in. Inhale, I choose. Exhale to let joy out. Inhale, I choose. Exhale to let joy in. Inhale, I choose. Exhale to let joy out. Letting your body and your breath be soft and supported. Then as you're ready, we'll start to wiggle our fingers and wiggle our toes. Taking a few moments just to send some energy, little sparkles of energy through the body. And then we'll reach our arms up overhead, point the toes. And then nice and slow, we'll come into a seated position to meet everyone back together. Feel free to keep the eyes closed for a moment just to keep this energy. Take your time arriving. And then take this joyful energy throughout you and keep that with you through the rest of the night and the weekend. Just remember to come back to your breath and come back to that breath of joy if you need it. And then we'll inhale, reach our arms up together. Exhale, draw hands down through heart center, and we can bow to one another to share our gratitude for one another in this community that we're building. Thank you all so much for coming. Bambi and I love you all so much, and we're so happy that you're here, and we hope to see you next.